All right, so right now, we have just got on to Interstate 55, right? 57.
55,
yep. Thank you. Came off and stuff. Interstate 55, which really is part of Route 66. So we are finally on Route 66, but the interstate part of it. And our first stop is going to be in Pontiac, Illinois, to check out the museum down there. And again, on Route 66. So here we go. Okay, you guys, here we are. We're in Pontiac, Illinois. Say hello, Debbie.
Hi there.
All right, and where are we at right now, Deb, in Pontiac, Illinois?
We are at the Historic Route 66 Museum.
And we just got here in the afternoon and making our way through, so hopefully we'll get to take you. I'm not sure if they'll allow us to videotape or not, let alone can we get in. Because I know with the coronavirus, the museum has been closed, and as I look at the door down there, I'm thinking it is. So with that being said, let's go, let's find out, come on. Okay, our adventure still continues here in Route 66 in Pontiac, Illinois, where Debbie has got some information on a bus we're standing by. What's the bus, Deb?
This is Bob Waldmeier's bus.
Okay.
He went with his family. He was born in 1945 in Springfield.
Okay.
And he began to really like Route 66 when his parents took him and his family on a road trip to California on Route 66. And so that's what he wanted to do with his life. So that's what he did is he went up and down Route 66, bought this school bus from someone and made it his home. His mom decorated the interior for him. And he supported his lifestyle by painting and drawing for people along the what he called the Mother Road, which is Route 66. And his works of art are famous worldwide. He purchased this bus in 1966, and it was his original plan. His original plan for the bus was to clear out the entire interior and create a living space complete with a bed and a kitchen and a work area. But the things that you can see in here, if you could see in there, were the was what he lived in. And he had a working shower in there and a working toilet in there and a kitchen. And here's some pictures of what it would look like inside.
The bus itself.
The bus itself, yeah.
Unfortunately, as I said earlier, because of the coronavirus, and especially here in Illinois, they haven't reopened up the state like they have where we are from Indiana. And so because of that, that's why the museum is closed. And we were kind of afraid to, on our trip that we would run into this. And, you know, and it's okay, you know, to check it out. But let's take a look at the bus as we're going around it here. This is the exit only. If you go inside the bus, the entrance is around the school. Some of the mirrors right off the bat, there's some of the mirrors that Bob did. Close up on that one. Okay, so right now we're still at the Route 66 Museum in Pontiac, Michigan, and for those that do know me, I am in radio, been in radio for over 30 years, and when I came down here, we're on the second floor of the museum, third floor, okay, I stand corrected, third floor of the museum, and here's a small radio booth of the 60s. Now, I didn't start in radio until the 90s for me, but anyway, as I'm looking, when I got into radio, a lot of this, believe it or not, was still, or was what I first started to work with. For example, as we look here, you have the board, what we call the board. Believe it or not, our board was in what we call the old Gates board, and that's what we had. We had the dials, we had the toggle switches, the one VU meter. But you know what the boards were really good for, at least ours was? And I can't touch them, but if you lift up the board, they were ran with tubes. So if you went to McDonald's, you went to some place and you needed to keep that apple pie nice and warm or whatever, you put it inside the board, raise it up, and by the time lunch came, it was still nice and toasty and warm. That's how we did it, okay? Also, you have over there the turntables, and that's pretty much it. For those of you, a turntable plays a record. And above that is the what we call the cart deck. For those of you back in the day, you might think, hey, those look like 8-track tape players. They pretty much are, but these are called carts, and that's where you would find not only songs on the carts, but you'd also find basically commercials, the jingles of the radio station at the time. That would be there. The other thing is the cart machines. There's a two single deck cart machines that are there. And if you look, that's where the carts would go in, okay? Then, over here, is the early days of automation. Radio today, 90% of radio stations, especially the small mom and pops, are not live anymore, pretty much voice track. And that's what this is, before computers, and they would play it back. And finally, the Associated Press. This is where you got your news from around the world. Today, it's by satellite link up. It's, you know, pretty much. Back then, it would be typed to us and sent to us, and we'd rip it off. So, a quick history of radio of back when. And oh yeah, for those radio gurus out there, they're using 634A microphones, just to let you know down here. Okay, there you have it. See you in a little bit.
Hey, look, our bedroom suite, or suit, we still have. I didn't know it was back in the 40s. Oh, look, there's your robe. The house of the 40s. Believe it or not, it looks a lot like my grandparents' house when they were alive. Dad's mom. A lot of the furniture that I see here, not the same color, but the design, the table, she had. She really did. Especially when it came to the kitchen. As you can see.
Okay, so we're in the band room of the museum. And Debbie should be playing the piano. Are you gonna play the piano?
I could tickle some ivories, if you will. They probably don't want us to touch it, So no, not too.
Okay. Yeah. Pretty cool, though.
Pretty cool. Who thought all this was in the
Route
66 Museum? And it is. They got a war museum. As we saw, the 40s museum for the houses and stuff.
Just pretty cool what they've got here.
And best part is, it's free, guys. This is all free to come in and browse. It really is, and it's really cool. So if you get the chance, make sure you stop here, okay? All right. Hey everybody, we are now in Springfield, Illinois, as is we, Debbie and I, and now we're at the Lincoln Monument and Tomb of President Abraham Lincoln. Because of the COVID-19, unfortunately, things are closed. It said what, Deb? That
it said closed indefinitely.
Yeah, so
the monument,
right, I'm sorry, yes. So anyway, we're going to try to give you what we can. First of all, all right, so as we said, Deb and I walked around President Lincoln's tomb, and everything is closed up because of the COVID-19, unfortunately. But if you get the opportunity, come on out here. It is something to see, I can tell you that. And like I said, when you come out here, you know, make sure that not only do you get a picture of it, but you also get a picture of Abe and the bronze headshot. That's what you want to do. All right, let's keep moving. Here's the deal, boys and girls. We are in Missouri. We are less than 80 miles from Springfield, where our first night's gonna come to an end, our first day traveling on Route 66. And of all places that we had on our bucket list, and you should too, is...
Yes, look at that. Uranus. Highway 66. It's got all, everything. We've got the world's largest belt buckle over there. We've got a funky dinosaurs even. We've got the Uranus City Jail. We've also got the water tower here. So much. So much.
And a mariachi band up on the roof.
Oh, I missed that.
So, all right, let's we'll be back with you. We'll take a walk and we'll explore.
All right, we're back. And wrapping things up here at Uranus, Missouri. As you can see over here behind me, got different things that you can visit. Now, the hours are varying right now with the exception of the store itself. The store itself is open until 9 o'clock local time. However, all the stores here that you see around me have closed for the day. They close at 6. Now, this is a Saturday, all right? So we're out here on a Saturday. And like I said, they have closed at 6 p.m.
It's gone. tattoos, by the way, too.
So like I said, this is, when you come out here, this is what you're going to get at Uranus. And a pretty cool place. If you're looking for that special candy, the type of candy that you haven't seen in years, like little Biddle Honeys, the Dum Dum Suckers, whatever, believe me, they've got it in the store. It's unbelievable. It is in the store. And they've got all kinds of stuff. You might want to check them out online. I'll bet that you can order online too. But they've got really neat things. We did buy some fudge. We haven't tried it yet, but we are we bought the fudge, and we'll see what we come up with. If we like it or not, I'll let you know, okay? But again, that ends our visit here at Uranus Fudge Factory, kids. So again, come on out here, and if you get the opportunity, check it out. I don't think you'll be disappointed at all.